What we do in the next few years will determine the fate of our planet for the next 1,000, said Sir David Attenborough, a famous biologist, in 2019. Our climate is changing, intensifying extreme weather events across the globe. But does that mean we're powerless? Quite the opposite. This is an opportunity. An opportunity to rethink how we understand and manage these challenges. So, how can we add value to society and move towards a better prepared, more resilient future? I'm Professor Joaquim Pinto, AXA Chair in Regional Climate and Weather Hazards at the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology in Germany. In the third part of my masterclass, we'll explore ways to quantify risks of extreme weather events, like heat waves and heavy precipitation, and how this knowledge can drive adaptation measures. One of the biggest challenges in risk assessment is the limited availability of historical data. If we have only recorded 150 millimeters rainfall once in 60 years, is this an anomaly or is this something we could expect? This is where climate modeling becomes invaluable, and I will explain to you why. Today, we can run computer simulations that recreate thousands of years of current climate conditions. They help us determine the likelihood of extreme events. And by combining this information with historical observations, exposure, and statistics, we can accurately quantify the risks they pose. Although climate modeling is computationally demanding, it plays a crucial role in decision making. We generate large data sets that support research and policy applications. For instance, comparing model simulations that include human-induced climate emissions with those that don't, we can measure the extent of human influence on both weather and climate. Such simulations are actually the foundation for the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, reports. So, how does this research translate into practical solutions? Thanks to high-resolution climate modeling, extensive measuring networks, and also artificial intelligence, we can now, for example, develop heat stress maps in urban areas at an astonishing 1 meter resolution. These maps, available for both past and projected future climate conditions, enable the quantification of risks for populations and critical infrastructure at the local level. However, our work doesn't stop here. To provide meaningful insights for decision makers, we employ innovative techniques like the storyline method. Here's how it works. We take a real-world extreme weather event, for example, the 2019 heat wave, and create alternative scenarios of it under different climate conditions. Pre-industrial, which is around 1850, and future climate scenarios with 2, 3, and 4 degrees of global warming. While the event's atmospheric dynamics remain unchanged, the background conditions, like sea surface temperature and soil moisture, are adjusted to reflect the historical or the projected climates. This method has already produced critical findings. For example, our research on the devastating Central European flood of 2021 suggests that in a 2 degree warmer world, the rainfall intensity would increase by 18%. Since the capacity of the Ahr River doesn't change, it would result in 38% more water volume flowing downstream. Given the current rate of warming, it's only a matter of time until something similar happens again. See the Spain flood in 2024. The same approach applies for heat waves. A temperature of 38 degrees Celsius recorded in France in July 2019 could rise up to 46 degrees Celsius under projected climate conditions in 2095, which is a 2.5 degree warmer world than today. With these new methodologies, we can now quantify risks associated with heat waves, heavy precipitation, floods, and windstorms, and also in urban areas where most of the people live. But scientific research is just the first step. Real progress comes from collaboration, bringing together scientists, policymakers, urban planners, and engineers in order to translate this research into real-world solutions. You see, scientists don't just inform policy. They also co-design adaptation and mitigation measures, including new engineering standards for drainage systems and urban design. One example of proactive adaptation is Copenhagen. Based on modeling scenarios, the city transformed much of its infrastructure to prevent flooding from heavy rainfall. The water retention areas that serve as flood management tools during extreme weather can also be used as recreational areas in normal conditions. Regarding adaptation to heat waves, cities can introduce water fountains, increase green spaces, and shading. You get it, building climate resilience can and should be integrated into everyday urban life. Ultimately, our goal is clear: to anticipate and mitigate the risks of extreme weather events, enabling societies to thrive despite future challenges and uncertainties. Let's do a little recap. First, scientists leverage computational power to analyze big data sets and simulate many realistic extreme events. Second, the storyline methodology helps us to understand how recent extreme events would unfold under global warming. Third, we are now able to produce high-resolution risk maps, for example, at 1 meter resolution for heat stress in urban areas. Such insights into specific risks, like increased heat waves or heavy precipitation, are essential for policymakers to build adaptation and prevention plans towards more resilient societies. Extreme weather is not a cause for despair. It's a call for action. By working together, scientists, policymakers, we can turn knowledge into action and build a future that's not just safer, but truly resilient.